Welcome back to Hardball, a new organization, Special Operations OPSEC Education Fund, or OPSEC for short, is going after the president for one of the biggest achievements of the Obama administration, the capture and death of Osama bin Laden. The anonymously funded group with Tea Party and GOP ties has a mission to go after all politicians who leak classified information for political purposes. But in their new documentary, they charge the president with taking sole credit of the raid and harming national security interests. Take a look.
They didn't. This administration didn't capture or kill or eliminate bin Laden or anybody else. There's a whole lot of folks in the military and intelligence community been working on this for a very long time.
Mr. President, you did not kill Osama bin Laden. America did. The work that the American military has done killed Osama bin Laden. You did not.
Democrats are already calling this a Swiftboat campaign reminiscent of the attacks on John Kerry 8 years ago, and they plan on fighting back against what is expected to become a TV ad campaign this fall. Gabriel Gomez is a former Navy SEAL who's a member of the OPSEC group, and Jon Soltz is president of Vote Vets. Gentlemen, thank you both for your service to our country. Mr. Gomez, I want to start with you, if I might. Doesn't the president deserve credit for issuing a very difficult order? This was a far from a certain mission. And in the process, we invaded the sovereignty of Pakistan. Do you give him credit for that?
Absolutely. We have always been to the conclusion that the president deserves full credit for giving the green light on the operation. It was obviously a very difficult decision to make. A lot of his advisors were against it. And he had to give him absolutely 100% credit for making the call to send the unit in to go get Osama bin Laden.
And it was something for which he was strenuously criticized during the campaign. He was called naive and worse when, during the course of the campaign, and I know it because he said it to me on at least three occasions, that he was willing to take that shot even if it were in Pakistan. And his political opponents, including Democrats at the time, they thought that was mistaken.
Yes, we agree. And we've never said that he should not have full credit for giving the green light on the operation.
So your criticism then is that this whole mission has become politicized because of the leak of the information. Isn't that 20-some minute video that I watched the other night itself politicizing this operation?
No, I mean, if you look at the whole video, we go through a lot of the points that, we give the president a lot of credit. But I think one of the points that we try to highlight through the video is if you look at some of the prior wartime presidents, you look at Lincoln, you look at Eisenhower, they only gave credit to the troops. And that's what we were trying to highlight in the video. The only time that these presidents, Lincoln and Eisenhower and other wartime presidents, ever used the word I was when they said, I thank you to the troops. So the point of the video really is to just highlight the difference between the current administration and how they viewed given credit as opposed to other wartime presidents that have given credit in a different way.
Well, I'm glad you brought that up because there's something that got left on the cutting room floor. You and your organization say the president is trying to take credit for the accomplishments of the military, but listen closely to what the president said in his address to the nation the very night it was announced that bin Laden had been killed.
Over the last 10 years, thanks to the tireless and heroic work of our military and our counterterrorism professionals, we've made great strides in that effort. We've disrupted terrorist attacks and strengthened our homeland defense. In Afghanistan, we removed the Taliban government, which had given bin Laden and al-Qaeda safe haven and support. And around the globe, we worked with our friends and allies to capture or kill scores of al-Qaeda terrorists, including several who were a part of the 9/11 plot.
And sir, it's not just that he said it that night. It's that I've heard him say it time and time again. Words like, thanks to the tireless and heroic work of our military and our counterterrorism professionals. So respectfully, where is the beef with regard to the president of the United States?
I think if you watched his whole presentation the night that Osama bin Laden was killed and he came out, I think that you would come to the conclusion, just like we did, I think a lot of Americans came to the same conclusion, is that he focused, I think, a majority of the comments on himself as opposed to the troops. We're not saying that he didn't thank the troops and he didn't give credit to the troops. What we're saying is that a big majority of the presentation was focused on him and his administration. That's the point we were trying to make.
Mr. Gomez, it's an uncomfortable position for me to be in disagreement with a Navy SEAL. Here's the transcript, sir. I know the statement very, very well, and I think that's a mischaracterization. Mr. Soltz, what am I leaving off the table? I feel like I'm doing your work for you.
I'm laughing so much you are. I'm wondering if Mr. Gomez is going to shoot another video where he sits there and says, we give the president full credit for killing Osama bin Laden, like he just said. I mean, in communications training 101, you don't come on and support a video like that and say the comments that he just said, which is the president basically did a great job in killing Osama bin Laden. I think the reason that is what you have is a lot of conservative, right-wing, neoconservative activists behind this entity. And so you've got some Navy SEAL guys that are out here. Basically, what he's saying is directly different on TV than what that video says. The president clearly says in that video, thank the troops. The president clearly ordered an operation to kill Osama bin Laden. That was very difficult to make. And let's talk about the war that I fought in. Let's talk about Iraq, a war that started because of faulty, leaked intelligence, a war that caused the vice president's chief of staff to go to federal prison for leaking the identities of a CIA officer. And, you know, these are the hardcore facts. So where are they? Let's talk about the issues that affect veterans right now. You have a president who opened the VA to thousands of veterans to come into the system from the Desert Storm era and from the Vietnam era in regards to Agent Orange. You have a Republican like Mitt Romney who said, who's running for president, I would not have moved heaven and earth to kill Osama bin Laden, who wants an endless war in Afghanistan that takes all of our tax dollars. So really what they're trying to do here is hurt a president who killed Osama bin Laden, ended the Iraq war, and has done, you know, has a budget right now that's given $11 billion more to veterans than what Mitt Romney's supporting.
I want to say
so
something
it's completely
else.
Contrasting.
I have no tolerance for those who leak classified information and jeopardize national security in the process. And I think it needs to be said that Eric Holder is pursuing investigations and prosecutions in that regard. Mr. Gomez, it strikes me this was the biggest news event in the 10 years since September 11, there was an insatiable appetite on the part of the media to get to the root of this. And part of me believes that regardless of what the president's predisposition might have been, and I see no evidence that he overstepped his bounds, the media were going to shake a story out of what happened in Pakistan. Where am I wrong?
Well, I'd like to go back to a couple of things that John said there. First, this organization, OPSEC, is not just a group of Navy SEALs. This organization is a group of former...
He's correct. They actually have a general in the organization who believes Osama bin Laden wasn't born. But no, they actually believe there's a birther in this video that believes that the president of the United States wasn't born in America. I mean, this is fringe.
All right, let's let an organization Mr. Gomez
that's,
finish.
That's
Go ahead,
like,
Mr. Gomez.
You know,
thank
9/11, you know.
I haven't interrupted John when he spoke.
You so haven't. Go ahead.
So I'd like to just you know, continue on what I was saying. This group has a large number of former Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines, Special Operations personnel, a large number of intelligence personnel. It's a very eclectic group. You can't bucket just one group into a certain political party. I mean, I would argue that John's group, the Vet Votes, isn't just one political
it's vote
party.
Vets. You can get it right. Vote
I'm sorry.
Vets.
Vote
we have 220,000 members, which is probably a lot more than what you guys have.
Come on, let him finish. Go ahead.
And my point is that I'm sure his group isn't bucketing into one just political party. So ours has an eclectic group. We've got Democrats, we've got Republicans, we've got independents. I myself, you can fact check this, it's all public record. I donated to Obama's campaign in 08 in the primaries. I voted for Republicans and Democrats. It's just like a lot of people in our group here, just like people that you served with in the Army, John. And same thing with my SEAL teams in the squadron when I used to fly. People have different backgrounds, different demographics, they're different political persuasions. You can't just bucket a group of people into one political persuasion.
Well, I don't think we are here. I'm not bucketing. I serve with people of all political persuasions, and I respect everyone's opinion, but there's a difference between expressing opinion and there's a difference between lying. And what you guys have done in this video is you've lied. Okay? There's absolutely been no evidence that's come forth so far. There's been leaks at all. Zero. Okay? You're basically saying the president didn't say thank you when he did on TV. And there's a big difference out there between telling the truth and us having a civil disagreement about policies on whether or not you support the Ryan budget that cuts veterans by 13% that Mitt Romney wants, or whether you support the president's budget, or whether or not you want a timeline in Afghanistan, or you want endless war like Mitt Romney. There's a huge difference in having that conversation like we are right now on TV, and you promoting a video that directly lies about the record
Gentlemen,
of the president of the United States.
I wish I had more time. I don't. Thank you both for your service to our country.
Thank you.
Gabriel Gomez.
This was a nonpartisan issue.
And Jon Soltz.
Thank you.
Thank you.